almost 3 months without a word. I have received a letter from my beloved husband, Jonathan. He's in a hospital in Budapest. He has been dangerously ill, the result of some terrible shock. But he is nearly well and will soon be home. If only I could be equally happy for my poor friend Lucy. Her strange illness is much worse, and Dr. Seward has brought her here to his private hospital. It is quite quiet except for Renfield, a patient who escapes from his room every day.
You can't catch me, Carnes. I can run faster than you. Please don't let Carnes catch me. Please don't let him lock me up again. It's so lonely.
Here he is, Dr. Seward.
Must you take him away?
Yes, ma'am. He needs treatment and should not be let out of his room. Come along, Renfield.
The poor man.
He is a sad case. He has delusions and sees things no one else can see.
I hope you can help him.
I'm sure we can, Mrs. Harker. I understand your husband will be arriving in a few days.
Yes. I am so eager to see him. He's had such a hard time.
I'm sure you'll be just what the doctor ordered for him. Just like your being here is helping your friend Lucy.
How is Miss Lucy this evening, Dr. Seward?
No better, I'm afraid. But I've called in Professor Von Helsing, the best rare disease specialist in Europe. She's examining Lucy now. If anybody could help her, she can.
Ah, here you are, Dr. Seward.
Professor, let me introduce Lucy's dearest friend, Mina Harker.
Professor Von Helsing! Thank you for coming.
Do you know what's wrong with her?
She has lost so much blood, yet shows no signs of anemia. She has difficulty breathing, heavy sleep, and dreams that frighten her. Yet, the most serious symptom, and the one she cannot explain, is the two small punctures on her throat. I have a suspicion, but I pray I am mistaken. Nevertheless, I must take precautions. Go to her, Dr. Seward. She must not be left alone. Mrs. Harker, will you accompany me to find the gardener?
Why does he want to see the garden?
Try to sleep now, Lucy.
But I'm afraid to sleep, Dr. Seward. Every night I have the same horrible dream. I see two burning eyes and a vicious face standing over me. It doesn't stay long, but it terrifies me. And after I awaken, I feel so weak.
You may sleep tonight without fear. I'll keep watch. If I see any evidence of bad dreams, I'll wake you at once.
Thank you, Dr. Seward. I want to sleep so much. Peaceful,
restful sleep. What do you have there, Professor?
Garden flowers. A cure, I hope. We must hang these around the window, the door, and the fireplace. I see you turn up your nose, Miss Lucy, but these flowers are strong medicine.
Very strong. I believe you are playing a joke to cheer me up, Professor.
It is not a joke. There is a purpose in all that I do. You must also wear a wreath of these around your neck.
If I didn't know better, I'd think you were trying to keep out an evil spirit.
Perhaps I am. Now, Miss Lucy, you must sleep. And take care to keep these flowers close to you, no matter how disagreeable they may be. Good night.
Thank you. the biggest bat I've ever seen! Get away! Go on! Confounded creature! There. Oh, good. It's gone. Good, she's still asleep. Now, Renfield, you know you mustn't be out of your room. Let me take you back.
No, I don't want to go back. I'll run in and you can chase me.
No! Wait! Renfield!
Dr. Seward, you won't find me for a long time. I'll take the flowers down. I know you don't like flowers. It's done, Master. I obey your every command. Do not forget my reward.
My nocturnal visits to you are almost over. Do not resist. It is useless. No one can resist Dracula. Soon you shall be as I am, and you will be entirely mine.